Welcome to Sweethearts or Rivals. I'm Sharla.
I'm Justin.
What's on our table today?
Francis Drake.
I have the box cover.
Yes, you do.
This game technically is supposed to play 3 to 5 players.
Yep.
But we're playing today with the 2-player variant.
That's right.
They're recommended for ages 14 and up, and it can take you 90 to 120 minutes.
Right on.
And this copy here is published by Eagle Griffin Games.
All right, so we're going to swap the camera around, and we're going to go through a playthrough.
We'll be right back.
Right on. We're back.
And we're totally set up to start.
Yes, we are. In the 2-player variant, you block off a certain number of towns and forts and trade areas and galleons. So they have been blocked off with the blue markers. Those are done. We have a die that we have appropriated from our Glenmore game. So we're going to be using this for the 2-player variant. And the first thing we have to do in Francis Drake is prepare for voyages.
Right.
Ooh.
And in setup, we determined I was going to be the first player, so I get to pick first.
Yep.
So what you do to prepare for the voyages, you have these really nice discs.
Yep.
And you get to place them along the path. So I think the very first thing I want to do, I'm going to pick up some crew, and I can get 2 if I put my disc right there.
2 crew for you.
Thank you.
There you go.
And they go on my crew spot on my player board.
Nice. So that's my go. I could put my disc on crew as well, because there's another space. I'd only get 1. Or if I want, I could jump ahead and get something maybe better.
Or different.
Or different. But I can never go backwards. You're always going forward. So it's a bit like Takedo or Glenmore, where you can jump ahead to the thing you really, really want, but then you're passing up a whole bunch of opportunities for other things.
But we always take turns, though.
Yeah.
Like the player furthest behind isn't always going to get to jump ahead.
Exactly.
Right.
So it's my go. And what do I want? I would like to get the shipyard.
I figured you'd do that.
Which means I am going to upgrade my ship from a lowly little frigate to the galleon. All right. Now, for the NPC player, the 3rd player, we roll the Glenmore die, and he's going to go to the first available spot, which is going to be the crew, and he's going to take the crew spot. Just like so. Now it's Charlotte's turn.
That's me. Well, I think I'm going to have to take 2 cannons. Sounds good.
2 guns for you.
Thanks.
Ah, you keep getting all the good stuff. So, I could go get 1 gun. But maybe I want to get guns later. Because right now, I could jump ahead and get good supplies. And that's going to give me 3 barrels of supplies.
And the supplies are going to determine how far you can sail on your voyage.
Yeah. Alright, so then a 3rd player is going to jump ahead and he's going to get guns.
I wonder what his plan's going to be.
He's going to plan on foiling us at all costs.
Well, I'm feeling fairly certain that you're not going to take the queen, which lets me upgrade my ship.
Yeah.
But...
Ooh, and get a cannon and a trade gun.
Right. Ooh. See, I'm thinking, do I get 2 supplies or do I go right to the queen right now?
Yeah.
But you're not going to take it, but you never know what Mr. Blue's going to do. He could get a 1 or a 3, but it's most likely he'll roll a 2 because I was thinking he... So, anyway, queen...
You're queening it up?
I better, even though I want those 2 goods.
So you get 1 cannon, 1 trade good, and you get to upgrade your ship.
Ship for me.
Alright, so it's my go. So, I can't get more supplies. I've already been there. I can't take the queen because you've already visited her. I could go to the tavern and try to get crew. I could go to the admiral. Get some trade goods? Let's go to the tavern. So, because I'm the first person to visit the tavern, I get +1 to the die of my roll.
I was just going with it. I didn't want to, bring attention to it.
And I rolled a 1. Probably because of my mispronunciation.
Yeah. You get 2 on the die of your roll.
Which means I get my ghost ship.
That's exciting.
Crew would have been better. So far, I have no crew and no guns.
Let's see what Blue's going to do.
There we go. Blue's going to go one.
Well, Blue, I could have gone to the queen.
Yeah, he goes and gets supplies.
You just never know with Blue. He's shifty.
Your go. Are you going to go to the tavern?
What's that other guy?
The Admiral?
Oh, he lets me pick what ships have which guns.
Yep. And he gives you bonuses for leftover gold.
See, if I go to the tavern, you're probably going to go to the Admiral. Then I'm going to miss out on the Admiral. But if I don't go to the tavern, I might not get enough people to even be able to get any fighters on the galleons.
It's crazy.
It's hard decisions. I'm skipping the tavern and I'm going to go to the Admiral.
You get the Admiral tile.
I'll just put him here for now.
Okay. All right, which means it's me and I'm not going to the Admiral because...
I took him.
You took him. Do I want trade goods? Do I want to become the governor? Let's go and grab some trade goods. So I get one trade good.
You don't have any people or cannons yet.
I know.
Oh, the trade goods go over there.
There we go.
Oh, I need barrels, or I'm not going to get very far.
Now, where's Blue going? Blue is going to, ooh, which means he goes to trade goods.
Oh, what a meanie. I don't like Blue.
Blue's a jerk.
I can't get trade goods.
Nope. You can get trade goods from the informer later on. He gives you one.
I think I'm going to have to go see Mr. Drake.
Nice.
Even though it'll time me up for two rounds, it might be worth it.
And you're jumping way ahead.
Way ahead.
Crazy. All right, so the first time you visit Drake, or the first round, you get two cannons and two crew.
That's nice.
Nice.
I have a lot of cannons now.
Right on.
Better get some sailing provisions.
I'm going to go hang out with the governor. And he'll give me some bonuses.
That's Blue.
Blue, right. Ooh, he's going to go get all that nice, lovely crew. Yep, there he goes. Jumps right ahead and grabs crew.
What a meanie. I have no choice but to finish up with the Drake. Or Mr. Drake, I guess.
Mr. Drake?
That's probably his name.
So you get one crew or one cannon.
Let's take a crew.
Crew for you.
Seem to have a lot of cannons.
All right, it's my go. What do I do now? I still have no crew or cannons. And Blue took the two crew,
well,
which is not good.
Just go and get one. It's better than nothing.
I'm going to have to. So I got a whole crew of one. Yay! Oi. Here you go. No, it's
Blue.
Blue. Blue's going to jump three ahead.
Really?
One, two, three, which means he goes to the informer.
Blue is a turkey.
Now it's your go.
Well, I have five cannons, so I don't think I'll go there. I think I'm going to go to supplies.
Okay. Two barrels. There you go. All right, so now it's my go. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm trying to figure out what can I actually do with the stuff that I have gotten. And I'm thinking, not a ton. I messed up on crew. I've got no cannons.
Well, you can get two cannons right now.
True, but you know what I'm going to do?
I don't know what you're going to do.
I'm going to go get the pinnace. So this allows me to sneak up on forts by going up a river, and then I don't have to worry about cannons. Just crew that I don't have.
Way to go.
Okay, Blue's turn. Blue goes three ahead again. One, two, three, which means he is in the docks.
Okay. At least we can all go there.
True. But it also means that he is going to be on the outbound harbor first, unless one of us right now jumps way ahead and just leaves, which I don't foresee happening. But it's your go.
Well, you're probably not going to go for the Golden Hind because you can't afford any extra movement.
Maybe not.
Or any extra, expeditions.
I'm certainly not going to get the Golden Hind anytime soon because
you need cannons.
I need a whole bunch of other stuff first. And that's the only thing you can do. Golden Hind, investor, or jump to the dock. So
right.
Might as well grab it and make sure you go first.
I think I might.
Yeah. So you get your Golden Hind disc.
This one.
Yep. Alright, it would be silly not for me to get a bunch of guns. So now I got two of the cannons. Haha.
Blue. No, blue's done.
Blue's done. This is where blue becomes the first person to sail out.
Well, I might as well have the docks.
Yeah. So you get one supply, one cannon, or one crew, your choice.
I think, you know what, I'm just going to take a crew.
A crew?
Yeah, it might seem weird, but I'm going to take a crew.
There you go. I'm going to get some supplies. Now I can voyage anywhere I want.
I see. Ha ha! And now my ship goes here?
Yes, it does. Blue's done, which means I got one more marker I can go to the docks with. And that's going to let me take another crew.
Two cannon, two crew.
I know. It's going to be a rough...
scary.
Voyage. Yeah. And then my ship goes into the third spot. Now, because I have the governor, we switch spots.
Me and you.
Yes, indeed.
That's horrible.
All right, excellent. So... we have our discs. We have 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then I have the ghost ship, and you have the Golden Hind, which means even though I'm first player, you're going to be able to do your first mission first.
Yay.
Which is kind of nice for you. Bummer for me. But I get to place our discs out, and what we do is we flip our discs face down, and that way nobody knows where anyone's going, what everyone's doing, and then I get to put my cube right there.
Because you have 4 goods and I only have 2 goods.
That's correct. All right, so before we put our discs out, the next thing we do is we work with the Admiral, the Governor, and the Informer, which we're not actually going to do anything with the Informer this round because Blue stole it.
Blue's dirty.
Yeah. So, you are the Admiral, which means you get these lovely ship tokens, and there is 0 cannons, 1 cannon, and 2 cannons. Mm-hmm. And instead of them randomly being placed out with the galleons, you place them wherever you desire, and you know exactly where they are.
Mm-hmm.
Now, of course, this galleon right here is blocked, so nobody's going to be fighting that galleon. But you still place one out there.
Okay.
And then we have one here, and we have one there. Excellent. All right. Now, because I am the governor, I get to do the same thing with the soldiers. Alright, so at this point, now we get to put our discs out. So I get to put my first disc out. And that doesn't necessarily mean it's number one.
Not necessarily.
And I have my ghost ship as well.
Ooh, that's so scary.
I know, isn't it? So awesome.
Terrifying.
So let's go right here.
Very suspenseful. I want to go there too.
Yeah. I wonder which disc that was.
Probably 4.
Okay, now what do I need to do?
I just realized something.
What?
That ship is in number 3.
Yep. Alright, so I'm also going to go there.
Okay. I'll go here.
Okay. I'll go there too.
I'll go here.
I'm going to go up there.
And for whatever reason, I thought this was a green area.
Yeah.
But that's in number 3.
Yep, it's gold.
So, I don't have any more trade goods. But I think that's where I have to put it, because that's the only place left.
There you go. Before I flip our discs, the next thing that would happen is the informer would let the person with the informer actually take a look at some secret information. But none of us got the informer. So we kind of skip it this round. And now we flip our discs.
Okay.
And now we resolve our discs.
Okay.
So, I'm first player, but you have the Golden Hind, so you get to go first. And you sail out to San Juan.
And I find Indigo.
Nice. I knew you were going to do that.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then I sail out to, what is that place called? Oh, that's right a galleon. Here? Yeah, that's a galleon.
Yep.
All right, now if I want to take this out, it's going to be 2 cannons.
I made a grievous error thinking that I could get to that galleon.
Ooh.
Yeah, because I knew you had 2 cannons.
Yeah. So, I blow up that ship, which means I get to take this lovely jewel, and I get to put that in here. Ha ha! And I get 6 points. Yeah! Plus, because I defeated a galleon, I get to take my cube and put it down here, because I defeated the galleon. And might as well take these back. Alright, now you're number one.
What happens? Because you already defeated the galleon.
You can still defeat it if you want. You'll get 6 points. You'll get your cube down here. You just don't get the jewel because I took it already.
Yeah, I think I will just so that I can
get
6 points and my cube here.
Nice.
Don't want to waste any cannons.
That's right. All right, then my number two, I'm going to trade in a trade good. And I'm going to take the coffee, please. Thank you. Mission number two for you. One crew.
One crew.
Yep.
And this.
And you get a piece of silver. And you get 2 points.
Yahoo!
And you defeated a town.
Nice.
Excellent. My number three is to go way up there against another galleon. Well, I guess I could have taken that one on if I didn't want to take that one on, but I think it was better for me to take that one for 6 points and the jewel from you. Ha ha. So I do not attack that galleon.
My number three, I don't have any trade goods.
Okay.
So I get nothing.
And then my number four, I come over here. Now, normally I would need a cannon and 2 crew. Because that, of course, has 0. Ha ha. But because I have the pinnace, I do not need any cannons. I just need 2 crew. And I can defeat this.
You're sneaky.
I get some gold. I've defeated a fort. And I get 5 victory points. And your fourth and final mission.
I'm here at this fort. So I need 2 cannons.
Yep.
Which I have. 2 crew plus 2 crew, which I have.
Nice.
So I get the silver.
Darn it.
I get to defeat a fort.
Yep.
And I get 6 points.
6 points for you.
Yahoo, I'm in the lead.
Yes, you are.
And that looks like all of our discs are back.
Yep, so it's my go, which means I'm the first person to get back to port in Plymouth. Which gives me 2 points, and then you're second, so you get 1 point.
And blue goes back.
Yep. Which means you are currently beating me by 2 points. However, there is 1 piece of gold left on the board, which gives you another point.
From my admiral.
Yep.
You rock, and you took admiral.
And you took both silver, which means I don't get any bonus points for that.
Yeah.
Then we take a look down here, where you also kicked lots of butt. You get 10 bonus points for having all 3 conquests for this voyage. I get a measly 4 for only having 2 conquests. That is
it's
sad.
It's funny.
And that is the first voyage, which means this goes here for voyage number 2, and we have to now wipe the board and set up again.
We'll be right back.
Right back. We're back! And we're not quite set up.
Not yet. We just wanted to show the randomization of blocking off these things on the board.
Yeah. Plus, in the second voyage, all the locations in the town for supplies are all randomized. Whereas in the first one, it follows a specific sequence.
Right.
So we randomize all those, which is very interesting.
And that will happen again for round 3 as well.
Correct. So now we got to roll to see what is going to be blocked off. The first thing we do is we block off 2 towns. Town number 1 is going to be Porto Cabello, which is right over there in green.
Wasn't that the one last time?
I think it might have been. And then the next one is going to be Portobello, which is right there. Now the 2 forts that get blocked are going to be the opposite of those. There we go. And then finally, there is going to be one trade location blocked off and one of the galleons. So the trade location is going to be Santo Domingo, the one in the middle. And then the galleon is going to be yellow.
Yellow.
Yep.
This one.
Yep. And then we got to put out our galleons because we haven't yet.
Ooh, he's the boss.
There we go. Let's see. So he's going to have a jewel there and there. And there's going to be some gold here and not there, right here. There's going to be some silver here and here. And I believe that is it. Haha. Our awesome galleons that we upgraded in the first round go back down to frigates. All of our stuff from here is lost except for our trade goods. And we are ready to begin another round.
You're P1.
I am P1. All right, so what do I want to do first? Wow, look at that. Drake, right there. Let's do that. I'm going to go visit Drake. So that means I get 2 crew.
How rude.
And 2 cannons right out the bat. I ain't going to be stuck without crew and cannons this time.
Well, if that's how you're going to be, I am going to see the Admiral again.
There you go, your Admiral tile.
He was nice last time.
Yeah. All right, Blue is going to... He's going to jump ahead, too, and go right to the Golden Hind.
What a turkey.
It's my go, but I have to stay and hang out with Drake for an extra day. Which means I'm going to get a cannon or a crew. I'm going to take a crew.
I'll take supplies, please.
Wow, you jump way up to supplies. 3 lovely barrels of supplies for you.
Thanks.
No problem. All right, which means it's my go. Nope.
It's Blue's Blue. Go.
He jumps up and gets more supplies.
See, I would have missed out on those 3 supplies.
It's true.
Yeah, he's a nerf herder.
Nerf herder. I'm going to go hang out with the Queen.
Really?
Because I get another lovely trade good, a lovely cannon, and I get to upgrade my boat all at once because the Queen is awesome.
Well, now it's me.
So, what are you going to do now?
Not upgrade my ship. Maybe I should take the guy that lets me place the people, too.
The governor?
Yeah.
Oh, my.
Let's do that.
Ouch.
I'm in charge of the Admiral and the governor.
That's not cool.
Ha ha ha.
All right. Blue is going to jump up 1, and he's going to take the pinnace. And that's my go. So I'm right at the Queen, so I could go to the tavern and get some more crew. But I think that's stupid because I need supplies. I've got none. So I'm going to jump ahead and get supplies, which gives me 2 barrels of supplies. You go.
I am going to go to the tavern.
So you get to roll a die and add 1 to it to see how many crew you get.
Let's see. Let's hope for the best one. I better roll again because it hit your frigate.
Yep.
Frigate all.
3, which I believe means you get 2. Actually, you get to add 1 to that, so 4. You get 2 crew.
2 crew, yeah. There you go. That's my first 2 crew.
2 drunkards for you.
They're probably all right. They'll sober up by morning.
Yeah, we'll see. So he jumps ahead 2, which means he goes and grabs some supplies. All right, so that's my go. I can get some crew. I like that. I can get some trade goods, and I can get some guns, but there's like 2 sections of guns way up there. So I think I'm just going to go get some more crew. 2 crew for me.
Now it's me. I best upgrade my ship.
Nice.
Or that guy's going to steal it, because he's not nice.
Yep.
There we go.
All right, and Blue is going to jump ahead, and he's going to get trade goods.
See, he would have taken the stupid ship.
He would have. I could get trade goods, but I think I need more guns. Let's go get some more guns.
I feel like I'm not going to be able to do much this round. I definitely have to take that trade good, because I don't have any yet.
Okay. Trade good for you.
Thanks. All now, right. What Blue's gonna steal?
Blue goes ahead one and gets guns. I could get more guns.
You don't need more guns. You've got 5 guns.
I do have a lot of guns, but I don't have the pinnace this time. So if I want to go out and be attacking forts and everything, I am going to need a lot of guns. But I think instead of doing that, I'm going to jump ahead and become the informer.
Because I have these two guys.
Well, yeah. And I get a trade good.
This round isn't going to be going so well for me. It's me. I need guns. Like, they're going out of style.
Guns
for
you!
So I have to get the first guns.
Oh, you don't want to jump ahead to the two?
Well, I'm hoping I can get the two.
Oh, yeah.
If he doesn't roll a one.
So, one gun for you.
That leaves me with a grand total of one gun.
Excellent. Let's see where he goes. Do you want to roll it? I don't want to roll it.
I kind of don't want to be responsible for this. I hope I roll a three. It's got to be a two or a three.
Yeah. He rolled a one. He gets guns. I'm glad I didn't roll that. Okay, it's my go. Where am I? With the informer.
You're either going to go first or you're going to go to the docks.
The docks. All right, so the docks will let me get one supply, one gun, or one crew. Right now I have two supplies, which means I can make it here. Let's get another supply so I can go at least into the gold section.
So I need guns.
Guns for you.
Yeah, way more guns.
So you get another gun.
Thanks.
There you go. And then Blue can't go anywhere except for the docks. So let's roll to see if he even goes there, because it doesn't really matter. He doesn't. He just jumps right out ahead and becomes first player. And this is my go, and I've got nowhere else to go, so I become player number two. And it's your go, and you can trade in your investor tile if you want.
I have to. Ooh, I don't have a choice.
Investor tile gone. So you get two crew and a cannon, or two cannons and a crew. Or you can upgrade your ship, but you already did that.
Yeah. Yep. So let's see where I plan on going. I can only get to the third place.
Although you can still go to the docks afterwards and get a supply.
True. But I think I might have to get more crew and cannons.
Yeah. So basically you get one of each, and then you get one of your choice.
Well, just give me a cannon, and then if I can go to the docks, I'll get it. That's a crew.
Oh, sorry. So give you a cannon?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then if you want, you can go to the docks.
I'll go to the docks, and I'll get a crew.
There we go.
And then I have equal numbers.
Nice. Let's
see what I can do with that.
Right on.
And then I go to number three.
Yep.
But... not
because
really.
You are the governor, you become first to set sail.
Yahoo.
Nice. Alright, so, the first thing we do is we give you these because you are the admiral.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Then because you are also the governor, you get those as well for the forts. You have all of your warriors out. Excellent. All right, so we're getting ready to put our discs out. We both have three supplies, so we can make it as far as there. Nobody's going into this area whatsoever. You go first.
Okay. So tense.
Yes, it is.
Now you have your stupid informer.
Yes, I do. Okay. So the informer allows me to do one of two things. I can choose a spot where I have a disc, and I can look at both discs. And then if I don't like what I see, I could swap two of my discs. Or I can take a look at a place where I have a disc and see what is available there for either that or that. And then, if I want to, I can move that disc somewhere else.
Where are you going to look?
I don't know. That's tricky. Very, very tricky. But you know what? I'm not really worried about how much crew I have there. Because I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've got enough. I'm good. So I don't need to worry about that. I'm a little worried about cannons. Because it's 2 there, 2 there. So it could be a lot of cannons. But there's nowhere else for me to actually attack a galleon, so I don't care again. So then it comes down to, do I want to look at these discs and see who's going to be there first, or these two discs and see who's going to be there first? Let's take a look at these two.
I can't even look.
Interesting. So now I could switch if I wanted to. So if I wanted to switch, I could do that.
That seems rude.
Haha! The now Informer!
Now we flip our discs.
Now we flip our discs, yes.
Why are you making me flip your discs?
Because this is part of you. Nice! And then you are sailing first.
So I do this.
Yep.
So I have to have two cannons.
Nice. Two cannons. Done.
I get a gem.
Yep.
And six of the points.
Yep. Okay. And take your disc. And then I sail to my first spot, which is right here, which requires one crew. I get a piece of gold. And I'm going to get 2 points. And that was a town for me and a galleon for you. Now you're number two.
This guy.
Yep.
One crew.
Yep. And you have successfully attacked a town and you get 2 points. My number two is over there where I have two cannons and three crew. Two cannons, three crew. Which gives me nice, lovely silver.
And six of the points.
Six of the points. And I have attacked a fort.
Now I'm on my number three.
Yep.
Three crew. One cannon. One of this. And 3 points.
Nice. And you have hit a fort. I go to my number three where I attack a galleon. I need two cannons, which I have. Which means I have attacked a galleon and I get 6 points. You're number four.
I'm going to take, let's see here, sugar.
And then my number four, I'm going to get indigo. It was kind of a bummer that I didn't have the Golden Hind because I could have gotten another trade good.
That's too bad.
That is very too bad.
I kind of didn't mean that, though.
I know. You are the first player to get back to Plymouth. Mm-hmm. I'll be second, so you get 2 points. I get one. Excellent. And now we score the round. So you get 1 point for there being a gold left. We both get 10 points for completing all conquests.
So then we clean up and reset.
Yeah, and we will start voyage number 3. All right, we are back. And we're set up. And we went ahead and just set all the random stuff up since you saw that last time, so we can just jump right into the game.
Right.
And you are going first.
Trade goods.
Trade goods for Sharla.
Right.
I am second player, and, what shall I do? I shall jump ahead and get the governor. Governor for me. Blue is going to go one ahead and get himself some trade goods. Here you go.
I'm going to try my luck at the tavern.
Ooh, the tavern. All right, at the tavern, you get this lovely die. You get to add a +1 to it. Ooh, you get yourself 7 for 3 crew. There you go.
3 lovely crew.
Now, I could also go to the tavern and get a whole bunch of crew. I don't know if I should do that. I could get the pinnace. I could go get a bunch of supplies. I'm going to go jump ahead and get supplies. 3 supplies for me.
Now blue.
Now it's blue. What's blue going to do? Blue is going to jump ahead one and get himself some lovely tavern folk.
I'll get some supplies, please.
Two supplies for you.
Thank you.
So I'm going to jump ahead past the shipyard and get some guns. Two guns for me.
Really?
Yep.
Are you not going to upgrade your ship this time?
Might not.
You're trying for the queen.
Or I might just not want to attack any of the ships.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Well, it's Blue's turn next.
True. Blue. Blue jumps ahead too, which means he is going to...
Supplies. I go ahead of you anyway, unless I take the guns, and then you could take the queen.
Hmm.
But I would only get one gun, so let's just go to the queen. She'll give me a gun.
True.
And a trade good. And a ship.
Gun, trade good, upgraded ship. Well, that's not good. Because, yeah, I wanted to go to the queen.
No, that's too bad for you.
So, now what do I do? I could go get two more supplies. I jump past the shipyard. I jump past the pinnace because I wasn't going to go after forts. I was going to go after all of the galleons, so that's all just destroyed. That was dumb. I should have just jumped right to the queen. What do I do now?
Well, you really did show your hand there.
Yeah. I go visit Drake, so I get myself two more guns and two crew. Which means now it is Blue's turn. Blue is going to jump two ahead and get some guns. This doesn't affect either us.
Hooray.
Now it's your go.
Well, since I have an upgraded ship, and you may not, I best get all those supplies.
There you go. My go. I have to stay at Drake's place, which means I get another crew.
And now it's Blue.
Blue, what's Blue going to do? Blue is going to go two ahead, which means he jumps right over to the Admiral.
Ooh, he gets the Admiral. That doesn't make me sad.
And sure go.
So, my next available spot is...
Golden Hind, or some guns, or right to the crew.
I've got to get guns, because I don't have any guns. So let's get some guns.
Okay.
That's for guns.
Guns.
How many times can I say guns?
As many gun times as you want, guns. There's your two guns.
Thanks, guns.
I'm going to get the Golden Hind. Might as well.
Because you get to sail so many places without your big ship.
That's right. Yay!
That's Blue.
Now it's Blue's turn. Blue is going to go...
One.
And get some guns.
Yep.
You got two crew and an informer.
Let's get some crew.
Okay. Alright, two crew for you.
Thanks.
So now it's my go. I could get one more gun. Do I need one more gun? I don't need another gun. Do I need one more crew? Nope. I don't need any more crew. I'm going to jump right to the informer.
Justin.
Which gives me a trade good.
I was thinking about taking the informer.
And the informer. Well, I didn't go for it last time, and you took my queen. So... I have to go get the informer.
It's Blue. What's Blue gonna do?
Blue is gonna jump three ahead. One, two. Oh, he goes right to the docks. There we go.
Good for him.
Slide.
The electric boogaloo slide.
There we go.
Okay, and now it's me.
Yep.
Well, I might as well get crew. No one's gonna block me from that.
True that. Two more crew.
Not worry about having too little crew.
Alright, it's my go. I'm going to go to the docks.
You're not even going to upgrade your ship?
No, I'm going straight to my docks.
Okay.
Where I am going to get another crew.
And I only have three guns. And I got all those barrels so I could go get all those galleons.
Yep.
But look how many guns they already have.
Guns and guns and guns.
So I have to go get more guns. And it's not going to be enough guns. Give me one gun.
One more gun.
Please.
There you go.
Thanks.
Then it's Blue's turn, so Blue's going to be player one. And then I'm going to be player two. And you're going to be player three.
These ships are drunk.
Yep. Mine especially.
Were we supposed to be driving our ships to where we have our discs?
Probably. But that's okay. Mm. If the board wasn't so massively big, maybe we could do that. But it just, it's huge. It's just a pain. Okay, so I have the governor, which means me and Blue actually swap spaces. Not that that really matters.
Not really.
No. Alright, so we're ready to set sail, but the first thing we do before we set sail is, because I have the governor, I'm going to place out all of those, and the admiral is taken by Blue, which means it's going to be random. I only have three, so I can only go to gold, and you have free reign of the red. Crazy.
And no guns.
And no guns.
Which I shouldn't have pointed that out, because now I know that that's why I needed the informer.
There we go. And then I get to place these out. Alright, so they're all placed out. So now we place our discs out, and I'm gonna place my first disc. I gotta get my discs all randomized. Oops. Let's do that. There we go. Excellent.
Nice.
Haha. Okay, so I have the informer. So now what I can do is I can take a look at, say I could take a look at these tiles and see if I already know what that tile is because I'm the one that placed it. I can also take a look at both of the tokens at a place where we both are and see if I want to switch stuff around. Let's do that. I didn't actually need the informer at all because I didn't get anywhere I needed to look at stuff. This is crazy. Let's look at this. That is a crazy surprise. Not going to change anything. Now we get to flip our discs.
He already had coffee. Oh. It's not so surprising.
Yeah. Yeah, that too. Oh, it's just silly.
I feel like Vanna White. Is that why you make me flip them?
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever.
Excellent. So now we set sail. The first thing I do is I take over the Golden Hind. So I'll take my Golden Hind piece, and I am going to get the tobacco.
No!
Then I get to do my number one, which means I get to take the sugar.
I don't care about sugar. Sugar's lame.
I don't know. It makes a complete set for me. Now you get to do your number one.
That's why lame. So I needed the tobacco.
Yep.
So it doesn't matter if I take coffee or indigo because it's going to have the same outcome either way.
There you go.
Indigo's more rare though, so now I can feel a little bit better about it.
Nice. Then I sail to the fort number two, so I'm going to flip this over. Oh, good. It was only one. So it's going to cost me two crew and two cannons. Thank goodness. I was like, yeah, I'll put zero here and here and I can get them both. Except I can't go to either of them because they're blocked off. That was just so dumb.
That was funny.
Yeah, it was kind of funny and dumb. Mm-hmm. Anyway, I managed to defeat that fort. I get a piece of gold. That's lovely. And 4 points. And I have defeated a fort. Huzzah.
That's my number two?
Your number two.
It's the ship.
Ooh, three cannons. Three cannons. But you have defeated a ship, and you get 6 points. And a lovely jewel. Then I go to the town number three, which will cost me one crew. And I get 2 points. And some lovely silver.
It won't go in.
I got it. And I have defeated a town.
Now, my number three is a fort. I need... How many people do I need?
Oh, right.
Doesn't matter. I have 1 million people.
Four and a cannon.
I have one cannon left.
Nice.
So I get 5 points. And this gem.
Yep. And you have defeated...
A fort.
A fort. Excellent. Then I go to my number four. cost me one crew. I get another piece of silver.
And one piddly point.
Right on. And I've already defeated a town, so it doesn't matter. Good.
And my number four is coffee. Okay. Trade, good. Which I forgot to pass in.
Oh, yeah, me
for
too.
My indigo. But that's okay. I had enough. It's not a big deal.
Excellent. All right, so there's no gold left, but nobody had the admiral. I took all the silver, so I don't get any bonus points for my governor.
And we each only get four points for this.
I expected you to take a town, and you didn't. That was surprising.
I tried to get a full set of this instead. True.
So yeah, we both get 4 points. And then I'm going to be the first person back for 2 bonus points. And you got 1 bonus point. I gave it to you. And that is the end of the third voyage, which means now we are going to take a look at our trade goods and what's in our treasure chest for our final points.
Ooh.
All right, so you got a set of 3 and a set of 1. So that's going to give you 16, 17, 18 points.
Nice.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and another 10 for 88 points.
That's wonderful.
And then I have a full set of all 4 for 26 points.
That's gross.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that's 65, so 75, 85.
Oh, you really caught up.
Ooh, I thought I was going to be ahead of you at that point.
It's really going to be down to these gems.
And I think you got more good gems than I did. I'm a little worried about that. Let's reveal. Interesting.
So it's 5 for the rubies,
yep.
4 for the gold,
and 3 for the silver. All right, so you got 23 points. 1, 2, 3.
Mm-hmm.
And then 20 on top of that, so 91 plus 20 is going to be 111.
Sounds right.
Excellent. So I got 26 points. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
We're tied.
And we're tied. We are tied. I can't believe we are tied.
So open the rule book and see what the tiebreaker is.
That's awesome. The winner is the player with the largest victory point total. Ties are broken by the order of the ships in the homebound dock at the end of Voyage 3. Winner! With the tiebreaker! That was crazy. I did not expect to win. I thought you had one more of those.
I wish I had one more of those.
Yeah. Because you had one more than me, but I had an extra gem than you did.
And I had, yeah, see, because I had beat all of the ships each round, but you beat one before me that one time.
Yeah. And it's actually not a tie.
How come?
I still have my investor, so I get an extra 4 points. Oops. Forgot about that. But that was good.
Not a tie, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Would have been better if you had won the tie. And then I won.
It would have just been better if I won the whole game.
So.
That's Francis Drake.
With the 2-player variant.
Thanks for watching.
Thanks a lot.
We'll see you in the next video.
Laters. I am going to get some more supplies.
That is not a marker.
That is definitely not a marker. Yep. What are you going to do?
Not the queen. I mean.
There's a blooper. That was awesome. Not the queen.
So great. Not really. I'm so embarrassed. Just All right. Ask me again.
Yeah.